As soon as Mr. T saw me get my camera out, he turned away. He was walking over to Buddy. He's like, oh shit, he's got that camera. I'm out here. So I'm sitting out here drinking my coffee, reading the Drudge Report, and there's an article in there about work-free weekends. And it talks about people and smartphones and how we've lost the ability to disconnect and disengage. And it took unions years to try and get weekends and nights off, because bosses used to just work their employees to death, and everybody needed a job, and there were few jobs, kind of like it's going now. So bosses now feel that they can require more from their employees because there's so many people wanting jobs. So this article talked about on the weekends, people can't disengage. They have their phone. The average person checks the phone, I think, 120 times a day or something like that. Their smartphones, and they're checking their emails, and they're checking all this stuff. So as it goes on, they did a study. Hi, Smokey. Hi, YouTubies. Mr. T better not eat that tree. So they did a study, at, and I haven't read the study, but it seems reasonable to me, and it ties right into horsemanship. The study said that when the body doesn't have downtime to disengage, it stifles, stops, or prevents critical thinking. It makes people numb. It makes people in routines. It puts them in the same frame of mind over and over again, and it stops long-term memory. Because when you're doing routine tasks over and over again, you don't have that downtime for critical thinking to kind of like pop in, so you can kind of just reflect and relax. And that's exactly, I mean, I didn't need to have a study from leading university that cost umpteen $100 million to tell me that, because in horsemanship, if you've been around for a while, you've heard the term or the phrase, give your horse time to relax. Let that soak in. Don't keep working him over and over because you stop learning. When you teach your horse something, stop, let him relax. You've heard me talk about the post of knowledge or the tree of knowledge, where after I work a horse, I go and I let him, I wonder if Buddy's going to find those roses. Obviously he doesn't like those bushes. So the post of knowledge or the tree of knowledge, sometimes tying a horse, it kind of stops them from doing a bunch of tasks, and it allows the things to soak in. You'll hear other people stop training and go, okay, just relax and allow that to soak in. You get breaks when you go to college, because if they work you continuously with no breaks, you stop learning. Same thing happens with horses. I lost Mr. T. I don't mind losing Mr. T too much, because there he is. He's pretty good. He don't cause problems. The little chickens back there, I don't know if you can see them. They're starting to roam around and fill their oats. They were flapping their wings, learning how to fly the other day. It was pretty cute. So anyway, oh, here goes Buddy on the move. You're going to get in trouble. Allowing things to soak in, allowing your horse time to relax. That's why when loud hands make loud horses. When you're always in your horse's face, when you're always controlling his head, lower your head, stand still, don't move, you're pulling on a bit, you're restricting his head, you won't let him eat, you make him keep his head, you just constantly, the whole time you're on a horse's back, you nag, 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 and you never let the horse relax and let things soak in. You don't give him time to critically think and learn and process what he's learned. And when he doesn't learn, Buddy walked behind the truck there. I'm going to look at Buddy's back. Walk over here on the rocks barefooted. Ow, ow. Buddy, I'm trying to keep you in the camera so I can talk. She's like, dude, I don't care what you're doing. I'm busy. I'm relaxing. I'm soaking in my lessons of the night from running from predators on a Serengeti. So, when you're working your horse, give them time. That's why I'm a biggie. When you're sitting on a horse, make sure the reins are loose. Make sure you're not always putting pressure. Make sure you're not wiggling around. Don't be answering your cell phone and getting distracted. Don't be checking your emails. Don't be on the phone talking to someone else when you're on a horse. those stop you from learning and advancing in your horsemanship. And now, of course, there's a study that backs this up, and maybe people will be able to connect this with their horsemanship and learn that Buddy's not going to stand still. I'm going to kill him. I'm going to tie that damn horse up. Stupid horse. Relax. Let your horse take a snack. Your horse doesn't have to be on the job every time you're on him. That's why I'm not a big proponent of this. Respect my space. Stay out of my space. Stand still. Don't move. Don't pull her up. Don't eat. Don't. Let your horse be a horse so he can learn. He'll learn better. He'll learn quicker. And he'll retain more. And like I said, that's been around horsemanship for years. I didn't need no million-dollar study to tell me that, but evidently, the dummies, the stupid humans, the smart, supposedly smarter, dumber animal who's got cell phones couldn't figure that out without some big study. Anyway, thought it was interesting. You can look it up. I'm sure the report's out there if you Google it. I thought it was interesting. Haven't found a study. If I find a study, I'll put it in link. All right, let your horse relax sometimes. Quit being a pain in the butt. Buddy, you're a good boy. He's like, dude, I'm relaxing. Leave me alone.